In the video on binomial distribution, we have imagined transcription as a coin toss. We discretize time. At each time point, a coin is tossed. If it is head, we have a mRNA. Now, we have a numerical problem on transcription. Suppose the average rate of transcription is 1 mRNA per second. What is the probability that 8 mRNAs will be produced in 10 seconds? In a deterministic system, we should get 10 mRNAs in 10 seconds. But transcription is stochastic, so we may get more or less. It is a matter of probability. So let's calculate the probability using binomial distribution. Break time in intervals of 1 second. So there are 10 time points in 10 seconds. We can say we have n equal to 10 trials. On each trial, either a mRNA is produced or nothing happens. The average number of mRNA produced is 10. In binomial distribution, mean is equal to n into p. So the probability of having a mRNA, p is equal to mu by n, that is 1. Now we are ready to use the PMF of binomial distribution. The probability that 8 copies of mRNA will be made in 10 seconds is given by the PMF, n choose k, p to the power k into 1 minus p to the power n minus k. Here k is 8, n is 10 and p is 1. Plugging those values, we get 0. That is an unexpected and unrealistic answer. Let's try again. Now discretize time in much smaller intervals. Consider each interval as 1 millisecond. So del t is equal to 0.001 second. So number of trials in 10 seconds is now 10,000. Mean remain the same, but the probability changes. Now p is equal to 0.001. Use these updated values of n and p to calculate the probability again, using the same binomial PMF. Now the probability is 0.1126. This probability makes some sense. However, how do you know that this result is correct? The result of our calculation is changing with the time scale used for discretization. That is not acceptable. The problem in our approach is elementary. Time is continuous, not discrete. However, we are dividing time into discrete intervals. This discretization is leading to an error in our estimates. The generic solution to this problem is to make the intervals infinitesimally small. That means del t tends to 0. When del t tends to 0, n, the number of trials, tends to infinity. Now evaluate the general form of the binomial PMF with this limit. Replace p with mu divided by n. Now expand n choose k in terms of factorials and simplify it. Mu to the power k and factorial k does not depend upon n. So take those two terms out of the limit. This numerator is product of k terms. When n tends to infinity, this product is equal to n to the power k. So we get 1. When n tends to infinity, 1 minus mu by n to the power minus k is equal to 1. By definition, when n tends to infinity, 1 minus mu by n to the power n is equal to e to the power minus mu. That brings us to a reduced form for the probability. Probability of x equal to k is equal to mu to the power k divided by factorial k into e to the power minus mu. This is quite a relief. The right hand side of this equation is independent of n, del t and p. It only depends upon mu and k that we get directly from the question without any assumption of time intervals. Let's use this equation for the mRNA problem. For our mRNA problem, mu is equal to 10 and k equal to 8. So the probability of having 8 mRNA in 10 seconds is mu to the power k divided by factorial k into e to the power minus mu. Plug the values of mu and k. Doing so, the probability is 0.1126. The function mu to the power k divided by factorial k into e to the power minus mu is the PMA for Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is a distribution of discrete random numbers. Here is the PMF of Poisson distribution with mu equal to 5. The mean of Poisson distribution is mu and the variance is also mu. In the transcription problem, we have discrete events happening in continuous time. Poisson distribution is useful to model such dynamical processes. We will use this distribution again in Poisson processes, but that is in another video. Till then, happy learning!